right, you know. Well, said to Tommy, you know, I never forget, you know, they say us Scotch folk are mean. But we are not mean at all. We're a very thrifty nation, and so are our dogs, as the following story will tell you. My dear old pal Mackay had a beautiful Scotch collie dog. He used to get a penny between its teeth every morning. It would go away to the baker's shop 3 miles into the village and get a morning roll for its breakfast. Well, one Monday morning, when it got the penny between its teeth, instead of going to the baker's, it slunk away into the kennel. The same thing on the Tuesday, the kennel, and the same thing on the Wednesday. So Mackay went and saw the baker. He says, look you here, baker, have you been outfitting my dog? The baker says, well, haven't I? We've missed your dog for 3 mornings and we're all very sorry. Well, Thursday morning, that dog got the penny again. Plunk, the kennel. Friday, the kennel. But believe me, in the Saturday morning, when that dog got the penny between its teeth, it rushed into the kennel, it picked the other 5 pennies up between its teeth, it rushed away to the baker's shop and it brought back 7 rolls for 6 pence. And I never forget, you know, the minister, he was preaching to a very wealthy congregation up in Aberdeen, but at the same time they were very mean. And he wanted some money for the renovation of his church. And in the middle of his address for this money, there was a great big bit of plaster. It fell off the roof. It hit Mackay in the head. He jumps up. He says, minister, I'll give you £5. The minister says, oh, Lord, hit him again. But I never forget, you know, the minister come to visit Mrs. Mackay one afternoon in connection with the mother's meeting in the church. And after a wee conversation, Mrs. Mackay says to the minister, will you have a cup of tea? He says, no tea. Well, she says, will you have a cup of coffee? He says, no coffee. Well, she says, will you have a cup of cocoa? He says, no cocoa. Well, she says, will you have a whiskey and soda? He says, no soda. I'll sing you a song. Since Bobby Burns first struck the lyre to sing all Scotland's glory, there's ne'er a Scotchman's heart will tire of Highland song and story. But of all the songs that Scotchmen sing, where Caledonia's accents ring, the song of auld lang syne's the thing, Presky to Tobermory. Should old acquaintance fill up your glasses new and sing this Bruin fine, for there's a wee soft spotty in the heart of every Scotty for the song of auld lang syne. Should old acquaintance fill up your glasses new and sing this Bruin fine, for there's a wee soft spotty in the heart of every Scotty for the song of all.